Hello, people. Welcome to another Heather live stream. We made it to another Friday somehow without having this baby. I don't know how that's possible. I thought the baby would have been born by now for sure. She didn't post a lot this week. Not a lot of like video to cover per se. There's about 45 minutes, and that's including like the 15-minute live stream she did on YouTube. She didn't go live anywhere else this week. And what other highlights? She made a Discord server, so that was interesting. It's still up right now if you guys want to join it. She has the did she post the link? I guess it'd be gone now, it'd be off the stories. I'll find a link for you guys if you guys want it. It's something. I exported a copy of it. I'm trying to get like a copy right before she takes it down. Maybe she'll just leave it up forever and it'll just be like a little community for people to gather who know of Heather. So there's that. There was also a wellness check called on her today because she was like complaining about complications with the baby and then she refused services. So that's classic Heather, right? All right, so that's like the itinerary for tonight. I hope you guys are all having a great Friday. It's the weekend. It is the weekend. Hello, Skeleton. Hello, Dylan's Eggplant. Hello, Nicole, Candy Brox, Cheryl, BCG. BCG, how you doing? It's been a very fancy week, BCG. I ran the poll. Let me see who's won the poll here, because I think it has to be this weekend, right? Let's see. 45% for this weekend and 44% for next week. I'm crossing my fingers it's not next week because I'm gonna be working, right? So I don't know, but that maybe that's just me being selfish. Also, I don't know, I just think the baby should be out. No more being inside Heather. Hotel Heather is a terrible place to be in that tent. So we'll get right into the stories. I was able to just put the live into the story render this week. So that's going to come in. I don't know if it's in the right place, but it's in like the right date for sure. It was on February 10th. So there's like a couple stories here and then it goes into the live. And then the rest of the stories. And then when she goes on about the Discord, I'll show you guys the Discord. I have like the very brief thing she said in her Discord. So I'll pull that up when we get a chance. I can't go too far in because Xavier's dingling got posted in there. So can't show that on stream, obviously, but I'll show you what Heather posted and then what she responded with. That's what the hashtag same with Jeeps means in the title. If anyone doesn't know what that means, Utah girl, thank you for becoming a member. We'll play it. We'll get into this.
Do you guys remember when I used to complain about, well, if you really know, then you know that I used to be up at this time and looking like $1 million and feeling like $1 million for
at 2 a.m. She was up at 2. That's a crazy time to start your day. I'm going to bed at 2 a.m. and then I'm up at like 7.
5 years ago, 6 years ago, maybe 7 years ago. Who knows? Remember last week when they were waking me up every day at 3 a.m.?
When Xavier was waking you up every day at 3 a.m.? I think in one of these stories, she basically says when they are waking her up, it's Xavier waking her up. She was kind of naming a couple days this week. Unless I'm thinking of last week. It must have been this week because I don't think I covered that last week.
Now this week, they're waking me up at like every hour to hour and a half. My hips still feel like they're in a vice grip. And other than that, I'm doing all right. But they're not allowing for any regular sleep. And I don't sleep during the day. And they've got me up every hour to hour and a half. God, please don't let me lose my mind. Please. I need it right now.
What are you going to do with your mind, Heather? This is also her merch. DM to place your order. What is this? This is like Xavier's Hollywood Hill with a purse. What does it say? Cargo Park? Canago Park? Ganja Park? I think it's Ganja. I don't know. That's a terrible font. Like, I can't read that at all, Xavier. I can read park, barely. Wow. I don't know what that says. Garage Park? Ganja Park? Get them while they're hot. $125 fucking dollars. Order or direct order payment via Cash App. I don't know. I want to pay $125 for any hoodie. That's a crazy amount to buy. A hoodie for?
We're live. Fantastic.
All right. So this is the live from the 10th.
What is going on, you guys? Today is Saturday, February the 10th, 2024. I am here with Xavier. Babe, do you want to say hi? Here he is. We are still in our tent. If you guys have been following along, I just want to do a quick 5 to 10 minute update on what we've gone through so far. What has been the response from the people around us, including law enforcement, the court systems, et cetera, and so forth, and what we have done to kind of get ourselves out of this situation. So I am 39 weeks pregnant and 3 days. My due date is February 15th.
She got it down to the day. I mean, that's pretty impressive. So, I was trying to figure out this week. What day of the week she switches over into like the next one? So she's 3 days on this. I don't know. I might be able to figure it out right now.
2024. So that's in just a few days. I have three children who are aged 10, 15, and 17 who I have raised as the primary custodial parent since the days of their births, respectively. When you guys know, I came out in a reality show that I am not very proud of, but I didn't.
So I bring it up any chance I fucking get.
Didn't really know what I didn't really know what I was getting myself into. I thought it was a good opportunity to expand my business. I had a content sales business at the time, and I thought that it would be a good publicity opportunity to get my name out there, and you know, continue circulating content.
What was the content she was making? Was this the sexy content? And she's like, I'll just go on Love After Lockup and it will promote my content. I thought you were in love with Dylan and being sex trafficked and all this other crazy stuff.
I also thought it would be a great opportunity to obtain additional and new social media clients. I had many clients for social media, ad copy, sales, marketing, direct to consumer sales, renewable energy sales, B2B sales.
She's really on the renewable energy thing too. I don't know why she's reminiscing on it so much. I guess she claims to have made a lot of money during that job. So maybe she's like, if I just had that job still, we'd be set. We'd have an apartment.
Basically just a lot of consulting for new business and development. And I did a lot of that for free, but I was also making, you know, a significant income doing so. In the 1 month that I was selling renewable energy, not working as an HR person, because I worked for the company for approximately 3 or 4 months in an HR function, and then also 1 month in sales, I made
I've never heard of that. I mean, maybe it's not that uncommon to go from HR to sales. Don't you need to like go to college for HR and stuff? And she was like, I'm just going to go into sales, which is like anyone could go into sales. Maybe they were like, you don't have the credentials to be in HR. Heather, you lied to us. You got to get into sales.
$1,000 to $2,000 per week. And I was doing very well in that company. Now, how did I get to here? Well, as you guys know, as you guys have been watching, I began being mistreated by my partner and significant other, who I was a star in the show with.
That star, I mean, it's Dylan. Dylan was the guy in prison. You guys broke up. I think Dylan had a couple follow-up episodes. You were out of the picture. You said the other day that you called the National Sex Trafficking Hotline and ran away with no money. But now you're just in the tent with Xavier. Xavier's the one who saved you, supposedly.
And he began to fall into some really negative, harmful habits. Like doing too much partying and being around people who didn't have the same goals and visions that we had for our family.
right? I wanted to work in HR one time. I was like, that seems like a pretty chill job, like just enforce policies or whatever when there's conflict. I could do that in a laid back way, but they're like, you have to go to college. And I was like, yeah, I'm not paying to work in HR. I'm cool.
We were separated by the abusiveness of the situation. And I unfortunately ended up taking the majority of the beating, so to speak, literally and physically. In the first 2 years, I had my own car that I had just gotten done paying for, a Cadillac CTS. And I pretty much lived in the car and also in Airbnb. I spent about $30,000 on those first 2 years in Airbnb. Literally 90 to 100% of my paychecks went for a place to sleep. The rest was to take care of my children in whatever way that I could during those periods. But as any mother who loves her children knows, doing, you know, $50 per child in food and, you know, lunch twice a week with your children, that's not enough. My children have lived with me their whole entire lives, and it was incredibly painstaking to be separated from them, as I still currently am. I talk to them as often as I possibly can, but these are children who I have primary custody of, who I have birthed from my own body, and who I have raised since the first day of their lives. They're ages 10, 15, and 17, as I said. About 18 months ago, I met Xavier after several years of being violently abused, very, very, very abused.
You had Xavier? I mean, I think you're about to say, I had Xavier save me. But yes, Ratter and Vam. I have it now. We got to play this. Well, I'll play it. I'll play it eventually. Don't worry.
Following that unlawful displacement from my home immediately after the show, I survived somehow all of these things. I filed reports about these occurrences and victimizations that have taken place. And to this day, I've had absolutely no direct follow-up from law enforcement or the FBI, and I have contacted both of them. I think
she did a little compilation of all the calls she did to the FBI, actually. It's pretty funny. One of them was like her, it was a recording of her watching a recording of herself calling the FBI and them just like not doing anything. So it's, I don't know. It's like Inception almost. It's like watching a recording of her calling the FBI and obviously getting nowhere. I don't know why she keeps doing it.
I made this available to children and under 18, so I'm going to be very censored here. I don't want to give too many details as to what kind of abuse I've endured. But I think it's important that children are hearing what's going
on. Yeah. What do you mean children? Why is she all about the children this week? She's like, the children need to know what's going on and everything. And like I was just about to say, why is today so special? Every other day she gets into detail about all the assault, but today she's trying to appeal to the children. No wonder you're getting your accounts banned.
Going on, because for the next subject, homelessness, I think it's just very, very important. There are people who walk by and they do stuff to us to, quote, make us look more homeless. There's nothing that you need to do to make us look more homeless. We've been outside without a single night in a bed since February 14th of 2023. That is one whole year, 12 calendar months. We have been living in a tent the entire time.
No, that is right, Molly. Molly Lollipops. I thought on the show she says she had an apartment, but it got flooded, and so she had to leave. That's why she was staying with Aunt Diane. Aunt Diane and Aunt Stacy was there.
I think it's so disgusting that people want to make someone look homeless. What does that even mean? Are you making someone look homeless, or are you making someone look addicted and dirty and like they don't care about themselves? Because the two are not the same. And I think that's a very important distinction to make. There is a substantial homeless population in this country. There are people living in Airbnbs and their vehicles. You would never know. You know why? Because we have respect for ourselves. Because we have pride in our self-care, because we are not, you know, going to dismiss our population as trash.
Yes, that's right, too. YouTube user 007, you're giving donations to stay in a hotel and you chose the tent life. That blew my fucking mind, because I remember her getting back that day and she was like pretending to cry and she's like, I'm so grateful. You guys put me in a hotel. And then she just stayed in the fucking tent. And I don't even know what she spent the money on. Supposedly she saved it for the baby, but she's over here crocheting $100 blankets. Like, okay, that's real cost effective as a homeless person. And she's like, I'm gonna put like strings on, I'm gonna put buttons on, I'm gonna put all this crazy jazz that babies should not have, but like babies also shouldn't be in a tent. There's a lot of problems here.
The way that general society has. When you walk by a person, you can see a child will make eye contact with me. They'll wave at me, they'll say hi, you know, they'll have a big smile on their face. And a lot of the adults with them.
Because you're kind of goofy looking. Can I say that? I mean, you're an interesting individual. I got a yetter tooth.
We'll share similar attitude, but then you'll see some people.
She's like a cartoon character, kind of. I can see why kids would look at her.
Who will really stare you down and just look at you like you are filthy, when that is not the case at all. I think that it's really important to make the distinction between someone who has given up on themselves and the type of assistance and help that they need in life, and someone who is doing absolutely everything in their power to change their circumstances. Xavier has had several jobs. I have had 20.
What are the jobs Xavier's had? I mean, like, I think I look kind of homeless, but this is my home that I, this is all a ruse. This isn't an actual, this is just a green screen. Could you imagine? And really, it's just like a sewer behind me. That'd be kind of crazy.
21 jobs, exactly. And I have been coerced, extorted, manipulated, pushed, lied, you know, or otherwise forced out of those jobs within the first few weeks or so. And in going back to complete background checks and everything with me is kosher, 100% solid. I have no criminal background. I have a bachelor's degree credits in the field of office management for healthcare administration, new business development, personal training, nutrition, and many, many other sub majors. Marketing, I took a 3-month course for.
How can you like fact check if someone actually has all these degrees or not? Like, I would love to see her be on like Dr. Phil, and Dr. Phil's like, I ran a background check on you, and you actually don't have any degrees. And like, Kelly'd be like, what? They must have erased it from the records. She would never admit to like lying about all this shit. I don't think she thinks she has this shit, even though she said before that she actually doesn't. Maybe she just doesn't remember that.
Marketing, healthcare administration covers.
Why is the audio going out? I don't know. Hopefully that's a glitch on her end and I'm not dying. What's happening?
You know, corruption. And I think it's really important that future generations are aware that just because a person is experiencing homelessness does not mean that A, they are a bad person. B,
you're right. She is the head homeless person, Angela. That's right. How you doing, Angela?
B, they are a dirty person, or C, that they deserve it. I think
my two favorite Angelas are both here. I hope you guys are both doing amazing.
I think that society needs to come together. I've been a taxpaying citizen since I was 14 years old, and I have been under the impression that we have processes in place to prevent this type of treatment for all of our people, whether you're a citizen or not. And it's very disheartening to see and feel and experience the abusiveness and basic neglect systemically over these past, 12 to 13 months. Prior to that, I still felt it. You know, I had my car and I had Airbnb, but that wasn't good enough. I was going to the system saying, something is wrong. I'm being targeted and attacked. Please help me. And no one was calling me back. And to this day, they have not called me back. And we're 4 years in at this point. So from the perspective of a relatively intelligent, you know, grown adult, who is 39 weeks pregnant, about to, you know, bring a fourth life into this world, I'm not okay with this. And I don't think that you guys should be either. And so I think that as a society, our next step should be, number one, isolating my case, asking for answers from local law enforcement as well as federal law enforcement.
So wait, she just thinks the credits are a degree? No, okay. Okay. I see where she's kind of going there.
And not just answers.
Like a half-truth.
But accountability. And for that, there is a dollar amount. So I think.
Oh, what is it this time? Is it going to be 60 million like it was the other time I heard her say this?
That would be absolutely the next step. And when I'm crowdsourcing, when I'm fundraising, when I'm telling people this is what I've experienced and this is what I need, if you can help in any way, please do so. I use Cash App. You know, if you can't donate, please send a gift card. If you can't send an e-gift card, please just do me the favor of calling local law enforcement on my behalf and expressing that you have seen what's been going on, that it's all public knowledge and most of it is documented on Instagram or here on YouTube.
What would they even say? I see this lady stream from her tent every day and she just says the same stuff. I don't even know if it's true or not, but can you go do something about it? Then when there's a wellness check on her, she's like, go away, get out of here.
You know, and tap into the other sides of my personality. I'm a mom. I'm loving. I'm a woman. I'm funny. I'm a good friend. I'm compassionate. There's a lot of content that I've created that showcases my real true personality. But the targeting, as I refer to,
I think Love After Lockup got her personality down pretty good
to it, which is the unlawful, slanderous libel, and harassment that I have experienced since 2020. As that, you know, continues, or
Mandy, thank you for becoming a member. Okay. So whenever something like that happens, we'll play Bad or Ram.
Rattering bam. Mattering bam. Battering ma'am. I'm the damn thing gone wild. Battering ma'am. I'm setting word not a mind. Battering ram. I'm the damn thing gone blind.
Bam, a lamb. But every time I play that, you gotta go sub to Smitten Kitten or find someone to sub to her if you're already sub to her. So that those are the rules.
Goes back to being inactive, because there have been several periods of inactivity with regards to those subjects. As it continues, or, you know, declines, my life continues to pass me by and I struggle to balance everything that has been said about me. If you Google my name, there is a lot of nasty content out there.
Smitten Kitten made that.
And reality is I have produced so much content. I mean, in imbalanced amounts where you can see my true personality versus the demonization that the rest of this targeting has created. Almost none of my content is based on me, you know, being a mean person. Most of it is either A, me being hysterically crying and terrified for my life after just having been victimized. And by victimized, as I said, I won't go into details. You guys can read more. It's been very violent, very graphic, like R-rated movie type of victimizations. I won't go into this because I said this was acceptable for children. But they have been on.
So JLKB says, I was Xavier's girlfriend, one of them, at least. He cheated on me constantly. I should do an Ask Me Anything or something, since y'all are so interested. You could. On Reddit, they would love that. I think Reddit would like that. You should. If it's legit, I don't know how you could prove it. I'm sure you could prove it somehow. People would be interested in that.
I'm going, you know, and for 4 years now, and they have.
See, look, everyone's like, wait. See, you already got their attention. You'd have to verify it somehow. I don't know how you would, like a little poem of Xavier's or something. I don't know. It's something only a girlfriend of Xavier would know.
Mostly all of them have either been spoken about, acknowledged, documented, or shared on the One Heather GEE or the Coco.Chanel.YSL account on Instagram. Also the HLG Forever _. So to be here 4 years later and still be dealing with the same sets of circumstances, I have all the education. I have never stopped applying for jobs. I have applied consistently to 40 to 100 jobs, whether they're remote, whether they're in person, whether I'm overqualified, whether I'm underqualified. I have applied at McDonald's. I worked at...
Oh, I want to see this McDonald's application. In what facet did she apply at McDonald's? Would McDonald's hire her if she was too crazy? Louise Harris, thank you for becoming a member. Let me get this back up. I might batch these if there's too many of them. Oh, why didn't it play?
Rattering bam. I'm a wild black bitch. Mattering bam. I'm black bitch, had a child. Battering ma'am. I'm the damn thing gone wild. Battering ma'am. I'm setting word not a mind. Battering ram. I'm the damn thing gone blind. Bam, a lamb.
All right, let me read this back here.
At one of the most prestigious hospitals in the world for 8 years and have nothing but glowing recommendations from all of my bosses. but I went and applied at McDonald's and I'm still not making any money. So we're not in this tent because we're dirty. We're not in this.
But well, I mean, you guys are kind of dirty.
This tent because we're ungrateful. We're not in this tent because we're bad. We are not in this tent because we deserve to be here. We are in this tent because we have been blatantly abused, blatantly ignored, and blatantly overlooked.
Your prom photos with that's do it. You should do it. Do you have like a social media account or anything? You could probably get some traction on that. If you do. If not, like you could. That's wow. Yeah, prom photos. That's something.
Our case, mine specifically, has been, and I use the term our because for the past 18 months, Xavier has been a direct witness to everything that's gone on. Just because he's been with me and knows me, his phone number has been leaked and targeted and hacked. And
Heather, you leaked his number. You did that. What are you? Don't be like, because he knows you and you fucking post his shit all over social media. What are you talking about? It's not our fault that we saw what you posted, you crazy Looney Tune. Like, what are you talking? Oh my God. Okay. I think Xavier just gives his number out and shit anyways to whoever talks to him.
He has been on the receiving end of the targeting that I've been receiving for 4 years now. I don't want anyone getting in trouble. That's not my point in sharing this. I want it to stop. If the only way for it to stop.
Well, we can't be gullible. Oh, yeah. Try not to be too gullible.
Stop is that people start getting criminal cases and go to prison, then so be it. You know, it's 4 years now. If there's another way to make it stop, then by all means, I choose the least invasive form of intervention to get us off of the street and to receive the justice with regards to the criminal justice system that is in place that I deserve. As I said before, I have never violently victimized a single person, you know, ever in my life, not once. I cannot count on my fingers and toes the times that it's been done to me over the last 4 years. I would need.
You've never victimized or be someone. There was a one lady who would like beg to differ, who said like you did a lot of things that you claim others do to you.
Need my fingers and toes, your fingers and toes, Xavier's fingers and toes, and probably a couple more people's fingers and toes. So I'm gonna keep it short and sweet and let you guys go. I just want to let you guys know that I'm for.
We should all reach out to like our prom dates, make sure they're doing okay. Be like, you know, I've been watching this crazy homeless person on YouTube and it got me to thinking, are you homeless? Actually, this might be a bad idea. Don't do this.
4 days from my due date, we have been promised by city officials, by Xavier's father, and by numerous other resources, including strangers and sponsors, that we would be in an apartment prior to the time that my baby is born. I'm hoping that literally someone shows up in the delivery room with keys to a furnished apartment. I don't know what else. I don't know what other hope I can have at this point.
That's a crazy like hope to have, that someone would be just showing up with keys. He's from Naperville, Illinois. Grew up a rich kid. I think we already knew that. Yeah, that he was rich. Was never normal. I mean, it doesn't seem normal. Doesn't seem very normal. I'm just trying to see if there's anything else. I'm bad at catching up with chat. I'm sorry, yes.
I've proven myself capable. I've proven myself worthy of all the good things that life has to offer. And especially the privilege of continuing to raise my 3 children and soon to be 4th. So if you guys can support in any way, please do so. My name is Heather Gillespie. I'm coco.chanelle.ysl is my current Instagram handle. But on there, you can find links to all of my other Instagrams. The people who have been trying to cover this up will intermittently hack into my old Instagram accounts.
Okay. So when I lived in Lansing, an hour away from Naperville, so when I was gone, he was with his ex or fucking whatever girl he could find. No dudes, though. Because, yeah, I seen a few people speculating that he could be maybe selling himself for, you know, money for drugs to dudes, but maybe he doesn't swing that way. And he's cheating. I mean, like, I think he might be kind of cheating on Heather. Well, if he could, you know, with chicks. He's got that Tumblr. It's like, it's a whole thing.
Change the passwords and not allow me access. So the one Heather GEE was at 17,000 followers.
I think like calls are coming in when that happens, when it like mutes her and then she got pressed something.
So I have no access to that one, but there's still a lot of really critical information on the live videos, including when fake members of law enforcement, so not real police, but people wearing fake badges, were chasing me down the street, picking me up by my neck and slamming me against a wall.
Then where were the real police? You should probably have called the real police if like you got Damagak coming after you and batamaramming you against a wall with their fists. My goodness.
Another fake member of law enforcement body slammed me to the ground at 14 weeks pregnant, knowing that I was pregnant while I was in a defenseless position, laying down on my back on a yoga mat. Two officers with witnesses and body cam footage.
Then what's going on with that?
So this is not a joke. Again, my name is Heather Gillespie, coco.chanel.y.
It'd be a weird joke. It'd be a weird thing to joke about.
SL, one Heather GEE is the other Instagram account. If there's anything that you guys can do, any donations, a safe place to live is really what we're looking for. Thank you guys so much for continuing to follow along with my story. I know that a lot of it is very convoluted. And I also know it's difficult to follow because, you know, these social media platforms are my only outlet. I've been nearly cut off completely from communication with all of my peer group, most of my friends, you know, and my children and my father, you know, get maybe 2 or 3 phone calls a day where we're actually able to connect once of those 2 or 3 that I call my kids more. I call my kids like 100 times a day, whether they answer or not. But it's,
Doesn't realize how crazy that sounds. Xavier's Chocolates, how you doing? Xavier's Chocolates. Xavier's X is in the chat, supposedly, telling us about prom and stuff.
It's been a very isolating period, and it's been very scary. And I use social media to capture all of the other things that are going on in my life. Such as, you know, fashion. I'll go into a store, and if I'm feeling really sad and overlooked, I'll go into a store and I will, you know, commit to buying one shirt and try on 10 outfits and make some content, you know, with that. That's
okay. I thought you were about to be like, I go into a store and I make a scene until someone cheers me up. That'd be crazy though.
It's not because I'm trying to dilute or confuse, I use this primarily for documentation, and that's why I call it a personal blog, but it's to show that even through all of this abuse, even though I'm living in a tent, I'm still a human. I still want to dress nice. I still want to look nice. I still want to feel clean. I still want to shower my body. I still want to brush my teeth. So that's where we're at. I know it's hard, like I said, digging through all of that content to find the factual stuff, but it's all there, I promise. Cross my heart and hope to die. It's all there.
Stick a needle in your eye? I haven't heard that in a while.
Anything you can do, guys, it's greatly appreciated. If you cannot do any sort of donations or funding, like I said before, phone calls, advocacy, reaching out to law enforcement, reaching out to programs that they say exist. I've been calling them for 4 years. If they existed, I promise you, I wouldn't be sitting in a tent. So thank you guys so much. Have a great day. Happy Saturday.
And then she went to do laundry, or maybe that was after laundry. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know about the order in the dig itself, but it was all from this day.
Okay, so we have made it to...
Am I zoomed in, or is she just... I am zoomed in. Oh my, mamma mia.
Nearly 40 weeks, you guys. I deliver, or I'm due February 15th. That's in 5 days. Today's February 10th.
Xavier is hiding behind the updates thing. He looks tired. She looks not tired.
I would be lying if I said I was not terrified. I'm more excited than scared. I just want to get out of this fucking tent and on to raising my children, you know, and just start moving forward and receiving understanding and explanations for how
for him.
Did Xavier just walk off? What is it? I don't know. Whatever.
This has been handled. But yeah, so we're 5 days away. Baby is approximately 20.2 inches long. And I'm feeling okay. Just really tired, you know, and heavy. So we'll see what happens.
She did that this week. She called her baby Great Baby. I don't get to keep up with everything as much as I'd like to during the week. So a lot of this stuff is fresh for me. But what the? Why would you say that?
I'm so big, you guys.
What even is this hat? This is like a trucker hat?
39 weeks and 3 days pregnant. 39 weeks and 3 days.
Oh my God. It's a weird hat. Yeah.
So since I became an adult.
When did that happen for you, Heather? Look at this. This weird. Crapping herself out.
There are a couple of words I struggle with. It's so weird. One is hot dog. It always comes out sounding like I'm from New York. The other one is Arnold Palmer.
And battering ram?
Unless I literally slow my brain down and say it like that, it comes out Arnold Palmer.
Okay, she's gonna mess me up. Arnold Palmer, that's what it is, right? Arnold Palmer.
What were we saying?
15 calories.
And now she sent a Valentine's Day card to her kids, I guess.
So I'm laying here. We have
rural. How do you say rural? And Sprite.
So from here, there's a platform here, right? Look, so that we don't get wet. That's the doorway. So I keep this over it. And then this is brand new clean. We just went to the laundromat yesterday and mine is clean. The platform ends right here. Okay. So that's all the space we have to sleep. It's about 4 feet. Xavier refuses to sleep in any of this area.
Why? What happens in that area? She's like, you know, a mom that's like, I just did the dishes and now all the dishes are dirty again. She's like, I just did all the laundry and now everything's wet and dirty because we live outside in a fucking tent. I want to know why Xavier doesn't sleep on this side of the tent, though.
Refuses. He stacks all of his bags up here from here all the way down. Refuses to sleep. That's all platform. So he lays right here. And then I have literally about 6.5 fucking inches. 39.
Heather, I think you're a little bit bigger than 6.5 inches.
9 weeks pregnant on a wooden, uneven platform with nowhere else to go. 3 to 10 times a night, he is waking me up, sitting up.
See, Xavier's waking her up 3 to 10 times a night. They are waking me up. What is he doing? What is he doing, Heather?
The door, doing God knows what.
God knows what. He's sitting at the door, waking her up 3 times a night.
Throughout the night. Real Xavier doesn't treat me that way. Real.
I love this real fake Xavier shit. Like, oh, this every time someone does something I don't like, they're fake now. They're just not a real fucking person anymore. It's not like they just people do shit that you don't like.
Real Xavier literally the entire pregnancy and the whole time, even before I was pregnant, he would talk to my stomach and say, I'm going to get you pregnant. I love you. And I would be like, dude, calm down. We're sleeping in a tent. He doesn't act like this unless everything is going well for us for longer than 6 weeks.
Okay, what? So this is the other thing. She was like, things are going good. So obviously something must be afoot. And now Xavier's evil. But when things are going bad, he's a good guy. I don't understand this logic. So basically what this tells me is Heather can never be fucking happy. So if nothing is going bad, she's going to make something go bad. Or Xavier's going to piss her off. Then if bad things are happening, well, then at least Xavier's nice.
If we're not being harassed for 6 weeks, all of a sudden they take out the Xavier that treats me like the queen of the world and put this double the size person in his space, who treats me like an option, who's nice sometimes, mean most of the time.
A double this, he grows too. Okay, the tent shrinks, Xavier grows. Yeah, right, things were going well. I didn't notice. I couldn't tell by all the fucking amount of bitches.
Does not allow me to sleep, acts paranoid, acts schizophrenic. It's not Xavier. It's 100% the targeting. Why do they only do this when 6, 7, 8 weeks pass that everything is getting better? What's the purpose of that? Xavier would never, ever in a million years be just not careful with my tummy. This Xavier.
What did Xavier do to your tummy? Oh, no. I can see it now. She's going to frame Xavier if that's like a stillbirth or something. Oh, my goodness. It's like, you know those dinosaurs you drop in water and they grow? That's like Xavier. The tent gets wet. He doubles in size. He starts becoming an asshole.
Then after I have a serious conversation with him saying, like, I need to use the restroom. I'm 39 weeks, 4 days pregnant, sleeping on this fucking wooden platform. I've purchased everything that me and my baby need. The city of Chicago is refusing us shelter or housing assistance until I have the baby and we can, quote, go in as a family. That's their words. I have 20 closed shelter requests. None of them have, they've offered assistance for none of them. After I'm done complaining about Xavier not treating me well, this is what Instagram puts in my newsfeed as the very first post.
I took it away, whatever it was, because I didn't think it was relevant. But it must have been a doozy. It must have been something. But Rocky Ramirez, thank you for the 20. Let me play us the... Whoopsies. I got to flip it over here.
Rattering bam. Mattering bam. Battering ma'am.
I'm the damn thing going wild.
Battering ma'am.
I'm said a word not a mine.
Battering ram.
I'm the damn thing going blind. Bam, bam,
bam. All right, let's see what this is. And yeah, that is what she said before. I'm rocking back and forth, eyes like silver dollars. Okay, pay attention to the support that disappears when you're too pregnant to have sex. What? Who the fuck was supporting you with sex? What? Refuse to be used as a sex doll or cannot offer value to ego of the oppressor. I want to press charges against everyone involved. Cancel grape culture. This is a very ominous post, Heather. Very ominous. I don't like this post. I don't like it at all. Holly Lynn, thank you for becoming a member. I will play the Bad Ram song again in a little bit. This is just like I said, a very fucking concerning. Oh, this is Xavier. He rolled a joint, because if you look back here somewhere, you can see weed. I think Mama Bear pointed it out. Where is it? Let's see if we can find it. He's like, ha, the best joint in the world. I thought it was like right around here. I might be, oh, is that it? No, I might be going crazy.
Perfect cigarette.
They're changing Xavier's behavior again. Literally days before my due date, about to be 40 weeks pregnant. Could go into labor any day now. February 15th is my due date. And now the sawed-off water bottle that they have me urinating in from the tent that they have me sleeping in for going on 12 months now, it will be one full year on February 14th since we've slept indoors in a bed. One full year of oppression out of jobs, out of income. The only income that they allow me to receive is income that I earn fundraising through my socials. And woke up today after Xavier, again, fake Xavier, imposter Xavier, whatever the fuck Xavier we're talking about, who has been here every single day for nearly 19 months now, suddenly has problems with the way that we have to survive. And
Hold on. So fake Xavier is now there every day. I thought he was only there sometimes when things were going good. That's when he shows up. And what? Of course he's gonna have a problem with how you're living. Do you like how you're living? Do you want to keep living in the tent? I would be impressed. I'd be like, oh, Xavier's finally like getting his shit together. He wants to get out of living in the tent. That's a good thing. Heather's like, I can't be bothered with it.
Engages in physical altercation with me around
what? There's a physical altercation? And then, of course, it cuts off, because it wouldn't be a Heather story if it didn't cut off at a random place.
This is really what you people do. This is how you choose to spend your time. So now, after nearly a year, February 14th, you can go to the highlight section of this page. It's at the top. There's a little section that says Airbnb reviews. You could go there and look at every single review that has been positive, because...
Yeah, but there is one really negative review. Did I save it? I think I should have saved the picture. I hope so. It was like, hold on, let me see if I can find it. Xavier and her started fighting. Okay, here we go. I got it. It was from Edward in Chicago. I don't know why I said it like that, but I'll keep playing this while I get it. I'll pull it up on screen for us.
Because I don't have any negative reviews, because I'm
in. As a negative review.
Guest, I pay, I clean, I mind my own fucking business. And for some reason, a year ago, Airbnb said, we're locking your account, blocking your account. As I said, I've paid directly from my own bank account every time. There's been no gift card usage. There's been no usage from a third party, which is all legal. But because you people are so dense, I have done everything directly from my own bank account to prevent issues like this. Here we sit, and I'm about to give birth, 39 weeks and 5 days pregnant now. And you have been trying.
It cut her off. The Instagram was like, okay, enough of this shit. We're done. So you guys want to see why she's banned off of fucking Airbnb? At least I would imagine that this is this. So this is from February a year ago, because she's like, it's a year to the date that I haven't been able to stay at Airbnb. As her previous reviews, she might be a good person that lost her temper on that day. Heather and her partner started yelling at each other in the kitchen and scared everyone else in the house. Three of our other Airbnb guests started calling us to inform us they were arguing loudly in the kitchen. I called her to ask her to stop screaming, and after a minute conversation, she yelled at me and hung up. She also turned up the music on the highest volume and opened up the bedroom door to piss off the other guests intentionally. I called the Airbnb support to cancel her reservation and put her out of the house, and she refused to leave as she did not have a place to go. Airbnb support took forever to respond, and as it was late that night, I offered her to keep her reservation if she could start following the house rules and quiet hours. She behaved after that and had no issues during the rest of the reservation. But that's still, I mean, like, that even kind of ends on a happier note. But like, no, there's no bad reviews, guys. It's from the People Be Tripping subreddit. Mamma mia, chef's kiss. So that's why. That's probably why. And there's, I'm assuming, probably other ones that she's just forgotten about.
So now, after the drama last night, literally I wake up, I'm sleeping. Do you understand this? I'm like this. Let me act this out for anyone who may need a little extra assistance understanding. I'm like this. Or like this.
Like how normal people sleep. Like this, you know. Are with your stomach out, yeah.
Right, holding on to my 40-week pregnant tummy, asleep in my tent.
Okay.
Because I've been denied shelter, 20 shelter requests, and someone is trying to open my Airbnb account that has been closed for a year, that is not being used. So again, someone is impersonating me, probably the same people who have been using my health insurance.
Why did we need the picture of her sleeping like that? I thought she was going to be like, and then someone came in and woke me up in an aggressive way. She was like, and then someone tried to get into my Airbnb account. What? Wouldn't you be happy if they were trying to reactivate it? Then you could take that shit back and you could get an Airbnb. I don't think she knows what she wants.
Probably the same people who have been using my budget and my sponsored money. Probably the reason why Xavier and I have not received a meal in, I don't know, 3 weeks from the sponsors. And
that's bullshit, because she was complaining last week, and then the sponsors came through and bought her some shit, and she didn't look too grateful for it. So no, there was last week that the sponsors bought her stuff. I don't know what she's talking about.
I've had to
improvise and handle everything. Probably all of those are the same.
She got a coloring book. I got a new sketchbook for $5 at Target with 160 pages. So we went from just like that angry rant and ramble to we're going to go coloring. It'll be a fun time. Be brave enough to suck at something new, like coloring. Yep. What is this? Is this an elevator or is this a bus or a train? Or I mean, like that's a building, but I'm wondering where they're inside of.
We're grabbing lunch. I need spa services.
The only people that take the time to criticize you are the ones that have less going on than you.
Oh, yeah? I don't know how this got in here. Maybe it's a sign. We got to go for a smoke break soon.
You will never be criticized by somebody who has more going on.
Oh, maybe I just kept it in because it didn't. I don't know. It doesn't matter. I was going to explain how I edit things, but it really doesn't matter. We'll do a couple more. I was just seeing if like we can make it to an hour, if there'll be enough. We might just take a smoke break early. Like I might do it in the next couple minutes here.
With my dad, if you go to the FTRs and the 100 GDE page, you could see I've been calling this out for 4+ years now. So they go down the line one by one impersonating my friends and family. They force me, they do it to me so that I'll have no choice but to speak out on it and document it so that their future generations of people trying to figure out what fucked up shit they're doing can just watch my FTR section and get an idea.
She thinks future generations are going to be still trying to figure this out. Heather, come on.
It's disgusting.
It'll be taught in history class. What happened to Heather Gillespie back in 2024?
My due date is in 2 days. Do you really think that this is the type of aggravation that I need 2 days before I give birth?
Right, which one what? All I see is BCG. Which one? Got a snark page taken down today? The people be tripping subreddit? Or was it a different, like, a Reddit snark page, I'm assuming. I think that's what the kids call the Reddit pages these days. Anyone want to buy me a BBL? What's a BBL? A Brazilian butt lift? Is that what she asked for? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Yeah, what GoPro hobo got GoPro soloed. Was that Heather or was that the other Reddit snark account that got jealous? Crazy train, how you doing? Because like how could she have not gotten the big dog taken down if she's so salty about it, but mysteriously this GoPro hobo one goes down. I don't know. Anyways, that's very nefarious. She shouldn't have done that. Let's see what this is. This is the effects of stress on pregnancy. Let's see what else she's gonna show us. Okay, so these are all the bat. So what stress can do to you if you're pregnant, in case you didn't know. I'm not going to read it because, like, I'm not pregnant, so I don't need to know this. I guess she's saying, don't stress me out. I think she stresses herself out, though. I don't think we have to do anything to stress her out. She just does it. I thought this was going to be more like a tutorial on how she's trying to work her phone. Oh, she's just showing us that, like, oh, she's blaming, she, so, okay, well, this is actually something to read. She's showing, like, loss of the baby, so I guess she's saying, like, if you stress me out, I'll lose this baby, it's your fault. I can see her doing that. So this says, because my father, knowing that I've been raped, beaten, robbed, and abused, and left outside to die among other adversities, is going to have a problem with my attitude? Unlikely. Oh, so like her dad had a problem with her attitude and she's like, must be a fake dad. Can't be my real dad having a problem with my attitude. My father wants answers just as much as I do. You people are ignorant. He has helped me call numerous shelters and heard for himself, and they've all declined to offer any assistance, including the city of Chicago's 311 emergency shelter department. If you're new here, you should do your research before you put your foot in your mouth. My family is off limits. You have ignored every victimization I've reported and completely ignored the ripple effect of your unlawful and unethical actions. What the fuck is all this about? She getting salty? Someone said something? Or did her dad like get mad at her? I don't know. I'm trying to read between the lines here. This was on February 12th. I was just gonna gotta wait for it to switch over now. Where is Instagram? They got it down there. Do your research before you come in here. How does this end? Unethical actions. Each of you should back off and turn your focus inward. And what have you going on? Why are you so focused on me, my business, and my family? Because you posted all over the internet. Trying to understand. That'd be like me be like, how come you guys are watching my live streams? What? Get away from me. I don't know, Heather. And you people be sure to keep me in a heightened state of anxiety always. Anxiety is a signal alerting you that it's time to pray. Okay. Her prayers are pretty interesting most of the time. And then she's just posting her belly with no audio. No audio. Okay.
Okay. So I contacted this civil rights department again for the second time this year. This is what they said.
This is her compilation of all the times she like called the FBI and stuff. And I think of like some weird stuff.
This is the second time in a year. They didn't even have enough time to go through my social media.
This is the one I'm talking about where she's watching a recording of herself talking to the FBI.
This is me calling the FBI for the 60th or 70th time. Four times only this morning. And they just hang up every
only four times this morning. Only four times this morning.
Every single time.
Just a normal day in the life of Heather. Call 911. Oh, now the keypad works. They've just made me go through this recording five or six times.
Please hold while I transfer your call to.
Xavier Chakos, thank you for becoming a member. Oh, where the hell is it? All right. We'll play this and then we'll take a smoke break.
Rattering bam. Mattering bam. Battering ma'am.
I'm the damn thing gone wild.
Battering ma'am.
I'm said a word not a mine.
Battering ram.
I'm the damn thing gone blind. Bam a lamb.
Alright, now let me get I gotta get this other thing up. Where is it? It's here. Is it here? Yeah, this is it. All right, you guys. I'll be back in like a minute. I'm gonna need another minute. Blah blah blah. Once I get the music on for you, I wanna do. Should I risk it? I think if we don't do the whole song, we'll be okay. Nah, I don't wanna risk it. I'll just do the normal music. All right, I'll be back. I'll be back. Okay. All right. Let me get this taken down. I don't need that anymore at all. I'll get this other stuff pulled back up. We'll take this down. Now let's forget to do that. With this music, I wanted to do the Donkey Kong music, like the Donkey Kong underwater level music. But it doesn't like when I do that. And then it copyrights us. And then the chat goes away because whenever I do an edit, it gets rid of the chat for some reason. I don't know. I don't make the rules at YouTube. I'm just here. I don't know, where is it? This was... What are we doing? It's just her throwback still.
Hi, guys. Hi. It's Heather.
Yeah, no, I didn't know. I love it when she's like, it's Heather. If you didn't know, I'm wearing a filter. It's Heather.
Hello. So as promised, I came.
What?
Hi, guys.
What?
So I'm convinced that the world is ended or ending.
Oh, this is just a dirty floor. I don't know what this is. Tap twice to add Raptor. It's just a dirty floor.
No, right?
Oh, this is the Dylan. This is the crazy Dylan huffing like helium or something. I'll let him do it himself.
I beat your ass and I'm supposed to kiss your ass, right?
You didn't even apologize, and you're supposed to kiss mine.
It's weird because he sounds almost Southern. It's a Southern Dylan.
You didn't even apologize for beating my ass. No, you didn't. I did.
So this car has been following me. I'm going to show you. It's about to come up. It's the same. There it goes. It's a Cadillac, the same as my car. And their license plate is not in me. This morning,
She thought Cadillac was following her. This is her just running on a treadmill.
I was eating my dragon fruit. If you guys haven't added me on TikTok and Twitter, please do so. The links are in the bio of the HLG Forever _ account. And it was Tony Robbins. He said,
I'm not going to say. These are all irrelevant posts. She's just reminiscing on the past, I think. And then she's posting like her, visit my blog, mercifulstorm.com. Bunch of nonsense. Got ChatGPT to read it one time. It was just like, this person named Heather is blaming everything in life on this other guy named Dylan. And I'm like, yeah, okay, that's pretty much what we've been hearing. Isolation is devastating the human psyche. Mercifulstorm.com. Is that Heather? That's not Heather, right?
I'm organizing. There's my little booty project. Painting that. I'm taking the buttons off this coat I got, my little thrift store expedition. I got that coat. Super excited about that coat.
Is this going to be... Hold on. I'm about to mute it. Because I don't know what she's... I don't know what she's listening to. That's a fish. That's not a fish. Is she playing some unicorn game where they're whipping things at her head in a unicorn?
Hi, guys. How are you guys? I'm so sorry for my fresh, bare face. I'm going to put on a little makeup after I drop off food to my daughter.
Oh, it's about 5:45 in the morning.
Like, what? I don't know, man. This was taken during the period of approximately 6 months that my car was taken over. Okay. I literally had nowhere to live. I was sexually assaulted and I tried to stay awake all night and in the gym and find safe spots to sleep during the days, but would be followed into public places and threatened or badgered, but I rarely slept. It was torture. No shelter assistance. No FU from any authority to this day. What? No F you? I don't know what she means by that. No F you.
I just finished out my workout and I'm walking over to the lake so that I could see the sunrise, do a little meditation.
Well, that sounds very peaceful. And now we're back to present day Heather. I don't know what that whole montage was. She was, like I said, feeling no follow-up. Okay, thank you. I'm not familiar with that. Is that an acronym? I think that's technically what it's called, an acronym.
So every one of those videos is me. Everything I claimed is 100%.
Of course, I know it's you, Heather. Whatever.
100% real and true, as it happened to me in my life in real time. I am there documenting.
Half of the shit, you're just walking around doing nothing. There's no evidence of anything. You're just talking.
The only reason I ever switched socials is because they would lock me out of the social.
You forgot your password.
To this day, no attempts have been made to contact me by law enforcement or the feds or any court system at all whatsoever.
Except when Dylan had his hearing with Marissa and you thought that was you for some reason. And you were like, I can't believe that you didn't want to go to court. Crazy woman.
And I am still in a tent. And my due date for this baby is February the 15th, which is in 2 days, 48 hours from now. So cannot find the videos for the Jeep or the Tesla stalkings.
The Jeep or the... Oh, yeah. Okay.
I swear to God on everything I love, they were there. 100% they were there. So they're definitely there. I just need to find someone who can retrieve them from whoever archived or deleted them. But once they're posted...
And that Office episode totally exists. I think, like, the human brain just makes stuff up sometimes. But she totally has the evidence, guys. She totally.
Said they're posted. So they're definitely there.
It's like a daily routine. We're going to wake up. We're going to go to Mariano's, listen to some crazy music in the washroom. Maybe bitch in the mirror. If we're having a good day, we're just going to do this weird I'm pregnant thing in the mirror. It's huge, though.
Happy Valentine's Day, you guys.
So we're at Valentine's Day. Almost at today.
Made it. Tomorrow's my due date. I have no idea. This woman has been following me now. I have no idea. I go upstairs to the bathroom. They follow me. I come down here. They follow me. It's the same shit. They want to be famous or something. So we're...
What? I didn't see that before. Hold on. We got to watch that again. She was just... That was a James Soroka moment, bro. She was so pissed. People were just living their life around her. Where the hell is this ball? Why can I not see? I can never see. I'm going blind, guys. I'm going blind in my old age. Okay, so we're 32. All right.
Happy Valentine's Day, you guys. We made it. Tomorrow's my due date. I have no idea. This woman has been following me now. I have no idea. I go upstairs to the bathroom. They follow me. I come down here. They follow me.
Maybe they just like you, Heather. Maybe that's what's happening.
It's the same shit. They want to be famous or something.
Because you're famous, right?
So we're...
just like... And now she's in the toy section? Is this a toy section? What is this? Balloons? You think she's showering? I don't think she's showering.
Since these numerous provocations in different various capacities, beginning first and foremost with the wheelchair, there have been about 30 implications now where they literally stop and draw attention to the wheelchair. I don't care. Yes, I almost went into labor last week, Wednesday. Yes, I was on my knees, could not walk. Yes, Xavier took me back to the tent that you fucking losers have been holding us in with the wheelchair.
You guys are the losers holding yourselves in the tent. What are you talking about? And I don't think anyone's drawing attention to the wheelchair unless, like, you stole their wheelchair and they're like, is that grandma's wheelchair that we left at the hospital while we were grabbing hot dogs and we came back and it was gone? I swear that's the same like blue scuff on it.
We are three blocks from the hospital. I would like everyone involved charged criminally. Everyone who's perpetuating false narratives, everyone who's using the likeness of my children, charge them all.
What?
Charge them all.
The likeness of you're the only one doing that. I hate these piss me off a lot. These mothers who were like, you're using my children against me. What the fuck are you talking about? How about you don't talk about your kids all the time? And I wouldn't even know they exist. I don't want to know about Heather's fucking kids. That's all you talk about is your kids and the one that's in your stomach. And then she's got a...
Please charge everyone.
This is a weird one. So she's just like, please charge everyone involved. What the fuck is happening in these streets, it says at the bottom. And she just looks very like this.
Everyone involved.
So I have no idea what the fuck that was about.
Happy Valentine's Day, you guys. I hope that everyone had an amazing day and no one forgot to tell their significant others Happy Valentine's Day.
Did Xavier forget?
And their mothers, okay? I don't know if you guys believe in making sure you tell your mother Happy Valentine's Day, but I know she loves it.
Does she? I don't know. Hold on. I want to know. I've never heard of this. But let me see. Let me see. Well, I don't need to pause it for this.
So please, wish your mother a happy Valentine's Day. Also your kids.
Why isn't this working?
I had a pretty shitty day, but a delicious dinner. And I'm finally getting a little bit of rest. And finally, if you are already a sponsor, thank you. And if you want to become a sponsor and you have any questions, my DM is always open. Thank you guys so much. Happy Valentine's Day. So I just want to disagree.
I don't know what that other thing was. Her just like crawling, not very sexily, just like, like, I don't know. I don't want to put it back. It's hard to put things back, apparently. I need a new everything. I'm going to step my shit up, guys, soon. Soon. The channel's been doing actually pretty good. So I'm going to invest that money back into the channel. But right now, yeah, I was just a weird scuffle across the floor.
With some people who keep on telling me, don't look back ever.
Because that's all she does is look back. That's why she's disagreeing with it.
Only look forward. And I just want to tell everyone, it definitely pays to look back. And I mean pays.
Yeah? How much money have you made looking back in your life, Heather? Out of curiosity.
To look back. Don't let them gaslight you. You're not a mercenary. You're not a scapegoat. Look back. Look back for a brief period and then look back forward again. But look back.
I don't know. Live in the moment. That's what I say. Live in the moment. Whatever happens, happens. Who cares about the future? What if we get hit by an asteroid like in 3 seconds from now? Are you happy with the life you've lived? Just live in the moment. Fuck Heather's. Don't look back ever. I mean, you do whatever you want, actually. Don't even take my advice. My advice is crazy too. Cakes Booty, thank you for becoming a member.
Rattering bam.
I'm a wild black Betty.
Mattering bam.
I'm black Betty had a child.
Battering ma'am.
I'm the damn thing gone wild.
Battering ma'am.
I'm said a word not a mind.
Battering ram.
I'm the damn thing gone blind. Bam a lamb.
I don't know. You guys are gonna get sick of that. You're gonna get sick of that. What is happening with this? Is this the end? No. This is just not playing. That's why. I don't know what all this is. Hold on. Oh my gosh. So like this is just, do we need to read this? Do you want me to read this? She says, yes, I have. Yes, I have. Yes, I have. She has. We'll start at 6. Turned into social media, crowdsourcing, and asked the community for help. Nearly every single day I complete for the record updates. That's, we don't need to do that. I've also tried speaking in person to strangers in heavily populated foot trafficked areas. How's that going to help? We cannot do any of these things up here. That'd be fine. I have kept meticulous documentation. Where is it? Yes, I have. Oh, you knew I was going to, you knew I was going to fucking call cap on that. Yes, I have. She says, nearly 500 pages of handwritten document. I want like pictures. I want like actual receipts. I don't want like a handwritten story that I've carried around with me weighing over 60 pounds. Seems okay. For over a year and kept it in a waterproof bag. How often do you think she goes in the bag? What if water got in the bag? Because everything else is waterproof. It gets water in it. I have taken to creative outlets and sharing, such as writing articles. Was one of these. I hope the first one was like call 311. But she's done all these other useless things. Useless things. She says, I am a mother. I have three beautiful children and one due to be born any day now. It's my turn for some criminal justice and for the system to work for me. I am a mother, not a street person. You're a street person and a mother. You could be both. I have a college education and no criminal background. That's both lies. God, please. Giver me mercy. Give me grace. Please help. 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 Yeah, shoot. Help.
Good morning, you guys. So I'm finishing up the baby's cover. I am due today, so 40 weeks today. My primary care physician ordered me another ultrasound to see, number one, if I have a good amount of amniotic fluid, if my cervix is still fully intact, or if it's begun to efface or dilate yet. We found that ultrasound is a lot more reliable than manual, doing a manual exam anyway. So hopefully St. Joseph's will be able to schedule that in the next day or two, or we'll have to go to Northwestern for it, but I'm getting very nervous. I'm finishing up the baby's car seat cover to protect him from wind or water. There's like another component that I need to buy, and it's also...
See, this is like she's preparing to live outside with the baby. Which is crazy to me, because you'd think like she was so sure that Xavier's dad was going to get her to the place, or that someone's just going to show up, or the city of Chicago is going to get her a place. But it's like even she knows that's not going to happen. But she really thinks she's keeping this baby. I don't know how the fuck she thinks she's keeping this baby. She thinks she does, or she thinks she is. Chrissy, thank you for the $10. My new favorite Friday night activity is hanging out with you guys in here. Thanks. Oh, I'm glad you're having fun. I'll play Battering Ram again in a little bit here. We just played it. I don't want you guys getting too sick of it. It's like, it's fancy. Maybe I should put like a rotating thing on there. I really wish I could just have that set up not manually, automatically. That's the one I want.
It's a little blanky, and then we have everything ready.
Everything. Okay. Yeah. What about, like, where's the baby going to sleep, right? You got the stroller. You got the car seat. Do they have a high chair? I think they're just planning on, like, having the baby in the car seat 24-7 or in the stroller. But there's no crib. Does she have a crib? Does she have, like, a little fucking... She can keep it in a shoebox or something? Oh, this is just, like, 4,000 views in the last 22 hours. Someone's going to help, right? Day 365 in the tent. I think you got to help yourself, Heather.
I genuinely don't know what to do, you guys. So I spoke with my primary yesterday, and just because I'm 40 weeks today, he wants to order an ultrasound to measure amniotic fluid, make sure that I don't have a slow leak, that baby's still good, and that we could just continue to naturally, you know, allow him to come out when he feels like coming out. It's very difficult to manage this pregnancy without one OB-GYN, and there have been...
OB-GYN? It's OBGY. Okay, whatever. It's Heather's show here.
And a lot of different, you know, doctors who have been involved. I call St. Joseph to find out if they receive the order, and it's just awful. I mean, it's like being passed from person to person to person to person who is literally enlisted to do nothing but play games.
the electronic medical records are not new, ma'am. All you have to do to see if a patient's order has been received is search their name. That's it. If you can, you can even pull up the fax queue and see what's still coming in that has not been classified yet. Why do these people keep playing with me? What am I supposed to do?
Okay, so I just made a little invention. I'm not going to try to sell it because there's just JJ Cole has one.
What the fuck is happening? You're going to get blown away? We're going to not Neverland. Where's the thing you go? Oh my god. In the oh, my eye is attacking me. In the Wonderland. Is it Wonderland? It's not Wonderland. Oh my god. The Wizard thing.
A bunch of other baby brands have one.
The Wizard of Oz.
These buntings that you attach to the car seat and baby kind of slides in. It's similar to that in what I invented. It's this blanket here, and
it is a blanket. Okay, that's not an invention.
What I'm doing is I'm incorporating the use of receiving blankets so that this blanket can be the outer shell and the receiving blankets can be disconnected through either a button or a ribbon and thrown into the washer. For anyone who doesn't know, receiving blankets are made mostly from flannel or flannel-like material. It's not really breathable and it holds in heat. Also, it's really thin, so it's easy to transport to the laundromat if you don't have a washer and dryer in your house. Again, I'm not going to be selling them, but just for us, I finished the blanket, you guys. I just have to get the receiving blankets and work out the button system.
This is how supervillains are created, guys. Not specifically with her invention. That's not an invention. This is the blanket with like a string on it. But imagine you're that baby growing up in this tent, and the tent's like with the wind and everything, and Heather's rambling about God knows what, and Xavier's smoking crack in the corner, and there's a mouse running around. This is how you become a supervillain. You'd be like, you don't know what it was like. That's, yeah. The fuck is this? What is this? This is her pregnant? I'm assuming pregnant. Right? I don't know what this says up here. It's blocked. Well, that was the Discord. That was a weird picture for the Discord. But this, very soon she's about to be like, it's fake Discord. I am they got a bingo.
Okay. So now I just created a server for Discord.
All right. So I have that. I have this pull up so we can see it. Like I said, I can't get too far into it because Xavier's dingling, but she thinks it's fake Discord. Let me just see. I didn't see what this said up here earlier. So to paraphrase something, think someone is running fake apps, labeled them as real apps and running them on my phone. Discord is one. Another is Twitter. So she doesn't think Twitter is a real app anymore. She doesn't think Discord is. At first, I thought she was going to be like, because of the update. But no, she just thinks it's fake.
I joined Discord in 2021, I believe, or 2020. It is not the same. It is not Discord. I'm going to do a screen record and show you guys. I might have to take that promo down. It's literally just some bullshit.
It's just some bullshit, huh?
The first person on my server goes and makes a post. It's called Unspeakables. Pardon me, Unspeakables. So, like, instead of me calling the courthouse being like, hi, are you guys operating normally? I can go there and be like, yo, I noticed these weird things in my community. The courthouse doesn't seem to be operating normally. Does anyone else see that going on in their community, et cetera, and so forth?
Et cetera and so forth.
I go on this site right now. In 2022, it was about technology. It was about things that were going on.
It was for fucking gamers to chat to each other, really. It's pretty much marketed towards gamers, but anyone can use it. It's just like, I don't know. It's like the MSN or ICQ. Of today's day and age.
You could create your own chat rooms and you use voice to chat and discuss. It is not like that. So I'm pretty sure that they...
It's literally the same thing. It's the same thing it's always been. Since I got on Discord, which is like, I don't know, 2018 or something.
They're in my phone again and doing unlawful fucked up shit.
They are in her phone again.
Creating a fake copy of Discord. Look at what they've got here. Look.
Yeah, show us and then I'm going to show you guys the Discord.
Look at what they've got.
So this is her... going into the app store and then searching Discord. And then there it is. And then she goes into Discord and she has light mode on, which is fucking insane. But I guess, like, if you live outside in a tent, maybe it gets bright and you have to have light mode on, but that's crazy to have Discord on light mode. And she's just showing people waving and entering and her welcome message. Why is it fake? What is she even mad about? What is she mad about? So what she just typed there, when Teslas follow me, they do so in a gang, never alone. Hashtag same with Jeeps, because someone up here, I'll get the actual one up so you can see it. But they said like a Tesla was following me. Fake Discord, guys. This is fake Discord. Tuna sent him a request. I don't know who Tuna is. If you guys are, if Tuna's here, I don't know if she accepted it. Not the Jeeps. I know, right? Not the Jeeps. I don't know why she's, oh. Okay, so let me show you guys. Where is it? This is it. So, why is it? Okay, here. Is that the beginning? There we go. I don't know. It took a lot to load there. So, she made this. People started joining because, of course, they're going to join. Someone says, what even is this? She was doing like waving stuff, but those don't show in the exported thing. The more people joined, and then she said, hey, how are you guys? Thank you so much for joining the Discord. I'm creating this community to report any new, exciting, suspicious, curious projects, happenings, or occurrences, IRL, and to just get a general read on the community and what's been happening in the world. This is not a shit-talking free-for-all. I mean, that's pretty much what it is right now. It's a space for genuine, productive conversations and discussions. So people just running. Then this one says, saw Tesla today. I think it was following me. Why do they do that? And then more people join in. And then that's when she came in with the Teslas always follow me in groups. Hashtag same with Jeeps, which is why that's in the title. That's what says that right there. And then first comes back with, okay, so since it was just one, I should be fine then. And Heather got off Discord and said, this is a fake Discord. No one had even said anything mean to her yet. Like, literally nothing. What, the Tesla thing? She responded to it. Crazy, crazy Heather. And then it just gets so much shit in my fucking shot glass again. This is so nefarious. Are you over by the AIDS Garden in Chicago? And more people just joining. I can't get too far in here. Anyone have any clue what's going on? I think this Discord is fake. I think it's fake Discord. Hashtag for the record. Heather, you need to go to the hospital. So yeah, she's gone. She's kind of abandoned this. If I get too far down, Xavier's pee-pee is going to show. If you guys want... Do you guys have a link? I'm pretty sure all you guys are in there. If you're not, BCG can get you a link. If not, then I'll post it in here. I'll grab it. But that was her nefarious Discord server. That's still up. You can see what's going on in there right now if you wanted to. I don't know when she's going to take it down. If she deleted that, maybe never. Maybe it'll just stay up.
I said it before and I'll say it again, over and over again. If I was your mom, if I was your daughter, if I was your child,
grabbed it.
Would you be okay with the?
I got you. I got to guess. I'll put it in the chat.
The way that this situation has been handled, And if you're coming up with the answer, absolutely not, then I'm absolutely sure that you should be doing something to help. Please and thank you. Why the fuck is my phone not running apps? Why am I not being permitted certain permissions? A Twitter account? I'm not Donald Trump. What the fuck?
Well, so she thinks like Twitter won't let her have an account. I think you need a phone number, like a real phone number, not a Google phone number to have a Twitter account. I don't know if they let you do it with just email anymore. I don't think you can. I might be wrong about that. But she thinks she's special and that she's not allowed to have a Twitter account because she's like Donald Trump.
I mean, this makes no sense at all whatsoever. I'm not reaching anywhere near. The only person I've ever heard of as being banned from Twitter is Donald Trump, right? And I disagreed with that decision 100%. I think that taking away people's voice is the worst thing that we could do. Mitigating the message, okay. But taking away their voice, unacceptable. What do I do? I'm 40 weeks pregnant. Am I being held in this house that I can be victimized further?
All right, so that's the link, guys. I have it highlighted here. So if you guys want to grab it before it gets scrolls up too high, because if I pin this, then the bingo will go down. So I want to keep the bingo pinned up there for you. Maybe I can. Let me see if I can edit the pinned tweet to have the Discord link in it as well, and then it could be linked both up there. Maybe I can do that.
Okay, now the last thing for a while is that I'm also experiencing the same issues with Audible, YouTube, and several other apps that have content that is widely recognized and known, whether it's a book that I've read myself and I know what the words are. They're changing the words, changing the meaning. So Amazon just gifted me a free book from Audible. I'm trying to download one right now. And it's like scary. It's like an anxiety producing situation, because how do I know that it's not going to be some weird lie book?
So you haven't even listened to the book yet. You just assume it's going to be a lie book. Do you have anything to show that like it's been changed either? Like, you're just misremembering things. Cheryl L, thank you for becoming a member. All right, I'll play Veteran Ram again. It's been, I think, enough time in between. From between it. I'm the damn thing gone blind. Bam, a lamb.
Whoa, Black Betty. Rattering Bam. I'm a wild Black Betty. Mattering Bam. I'm Black Betty had a child. Battering Ram. I'm the damn thing gone wild. Battering Ram. I'm said a word, not a mind. Battering Ram. I'm the damn thing gone blind. Bam,
a lamb. I can't edit it. I've seen you guys edit your messages, though. That's why I thought I could edit mine. Can I not do that? Hold on. Let me try something. I can't edit it. Can you guys not edit your messages? I swore you guys could, but maybe I'm just... I can delete it. I can't delete it. I have an iPhone. Maybe that's the problem.
You know, which is what they've been giving me in the past. It's not a big deal if, you know, it's like a fiction, but if it's a nonfiction and it's about, you know, something that helps you, a skill set or doing business, and they're communicating false information, it is a big deal. You're literally teaching yourself and brainwashing yourself lies. What the fuck? How do we verify this?
What is this? Oh, she's just showing us the audiobooks that are supposedly fake. All right, so this is her actually writing something. I mean, like, I think a majority of us aren't too fond of Heather. It would be different if she wasn't pregnant. If it was just her and Xavier being silly goofballs, not putting a kid's life at jeopardy. Be completely different. So the newest harassment is no one wants me and my grape baby. What the fuck? That our lives are a limited time only investment, and that I should myself while I'm still pregnant and do the world a favor. Who's saying this to her? And I'm not even celebrity. This is wild. Still no direct contact from investigators. So who do you think is investigating this? Investigators.
Also now.
This is a cute little thing Amazon's got for when your order doesn't go through. A little dog. Uh-oh, something went wrong on our end.
Amazon Fresh is not functioning. So I've ordered most of the items for the baby that's due today through Amazon Hub. Only four or five little things for Christmas for the big kids through Amazon. They all came, no problem. Now I'm using Amazon Fresh. I placed the entire order. This is the fifth or fourth time that I've placed the order in 24 hours. So my baby can go pick it up with her boyfriend and then they have food and I don't have to worry.
What baby? What the fuck are you talking about? So one of her other kids is going to pick this up with her boyfriend. They don't need you to get them that stuff. Like, they have fam. What the hell is she talking about?
And I place the whole order, you guys. Fill up the whole cart. And I go check out, enter all my payment info. And this is the uh-oh, something went wrong. Two times.
I don't even believe this. I think I'm getting wise to Heather's shit. These fucking cracked out eyes. Don't fool me anymore. I think she just, so people feel like, oh, we should donate her some money then so she can get food another way. No, fuck that shit.
Today, two or three times yesterday, and then I have to call fake Amazon customer service.
Fake Amazon. Pat, that's where Pat from Amazon is from, the fake Amazon.
And they're always on, you know, straight up bullshit. Oh, yeah, it should work. Just try again. Now they're trying to say try from another device.
So big, bro.
40 weeks today, still in the tent. I make status updates here every single day. If you guys are new here, you can go to the FTR section and check it out. I woke up super swollen today. I'm having.
Where is Pat? Yeah, we gotta show Pat Paula. You know? Pat, where are you?
Having a hard time squeezing my fingers. They feel like little sausages. I didn't even eat yesterday at all. So
what the hell is she talking about? She's describing very weird stuff. My fingers are like little sausages. I think this is what provoked the wellness check, though. The wellness check that she refused while I'll be throwing a baby shower. I don't know. Maybe.
That's weird. Why would there be a weird elevation in sodium levels if I didn't ingest anything with sodium in it? Just woke up, texted the kids as I do every day. 40 weeks, one day pregnant. I have to go potty.
The text that Crazy Train posted between her and her oldest kid, insane shit. She would be the worst person to have as a parent. I believe it. I don't know. I don't know. Where I got it from, it was like in the stories, and I almost uploaded it with the stories, but it like showed pictures of her kids. I don't like showing the pictures of the kids and probably personal information of others, and just a whole bunch of random nonsense. I don't know if that's the same thing. It might not be. I have to go check. Crazy. Are they recent texts? Because I might not have seen.
So I'm one day after my due date, and now the chatter has changed to say things, really, really shitty things.
The chatter, the word on the street.
They have broken us over and over again, which, as you guys know, if you've been following along, includes psychological manipulation, torture, calling you names, saying threats and accusations against your friends and family members, biohacking information from your social media channels, so that they have information about you from your past that they use strategically to scare, extort, et cetera, and so forth. I don't want any part of this, as I've been saying. I don't even want to stay here for St. Joe's anymore. It's just that I'm about to have a baby. If you guys can help us out in any way, that'd be fantastic. Where are my sponsors who have been with us this entire time?
Okay, there's a guy on you.
Because this just about, I would say 6 weeks ago, turned ugly again, where they stopped feeding us, stopped looking out for us. If you guys are listening.
So then this cash app. I don't know why I paused it. Now,
also, if you guys used my code to donate through Cash App,
I thought Xavier's dad was like paying for, obviously paying for the phones again and like giving Xavier money. So what, just use that money.
Both get $5. So that would be fantastic. If you donate me $5, you get $5 right back. In other news,
I hope nobody donated this $5. That would be enabling a crazy person.
You guys know that I am a weightlifter traditionally. Halfway through this pregnancy, they took away my gym membership, and then we started going hard, like going hard, pushing heavy carts, 200 to 300 pound carts, all the way from Chicago to the Northwest suburbs, back and forth, 100-mile bike rides, like intense workouts.
I wonder what Xavier thought of all that. I mean, like, I don't think they're really intense workouts, but I wonder how he felt.
I cannot stand not being able to work out. And I'm scrolling through my newsfeed and I see Dana Lynn Bailey's posts. I want to go back to the gym so bad, you guys. It sucks not being able to lift weights, or maybe create a home gym, or maybe hope that my apartment sponsors has a gym inside of it. And then lastly, you guys will notice that on some of my posts, they make my tooth look yellow.
Buttering the tooth, yeah.
It's not in real life. They call it buttering me. They also make my face look really fucking bogus and like add wrinkles and all sorts of shit. It's not how I look in real life. They've been doing this periodically. You'll find a lot of content where it's not like that. I've whitened my teeth. I've had Botox. This is not realistic.
You living outside in a tent, it doesn't age me at all. You know, the fact that I was just bitching about not being able to brush my teeth in the shower, it shouldn't yellow my teeth after I've had whitening. Nah.
And I continue to call it out and point it out and even bring it up to law enforcement as part of the harassment and stalking. And still no one takes responsibility. Who goes in someone's phone? A pregnant woman or not, but a pregnant woman who's already hormonal and like lacking in confidence and does shit like that. Like, you are not shit. You are not shit. If you spend your time breaking a pregnant woman down, ew. Just
no one's in her phone.
Why?
So what?
Do you guys remember when I used to come?
I was gonna pause it, but I didn't let me.
Complain about. Well, if you've
everything, you guys remember when I used to complain about everything? Yeah.
Really, if you really know, then you know that I used to be up at this time. And
oh wait, no, is that this? We're looping. That's the end. We're at the end, guys. That's it. That's all from this week. That is all she wrote. Did I have something else? I'm trying to think if I had something else. I don't think I did. Welcome to the end of the stream. No, that's I think it's better actually when the streams are like 2 hours or less, because I don't think anyone has time to rewatch a stream that's over 2 hours. I mean, like, I can't even watch a stream that's 2 hours really. So I've tried to been keeping it more condensed and less filler. But whatever happens this week, she has to have the kid this week. Like, she has to. Oh, let me see who won the poll here. Who won the poll? What the outcome of the poll was. It was 60% say yes. Would you want your kid to wish you a happy Valentine's Day? 40% said no. Okay. That's like pretty much 50-50. I mean, 60-40, but that's interesting. That is interesting to me. I didn't wish my mom a happy Valentine's Day. So I thought that's more like for the kids and lovers and such stuff like that. But I will see you guys all whenever Heather has this baby, or if she does some crazy like hour long live, then I'll do it like the day of or like the day after, depending. So we can keep up to date. And I don't think I have anything else. I don't know what I have planned for tomorrow. I don't think I have anything planned for tomorrow. I might do a members only stream tomorrow. That's what I've been doing on Saturdays lately because I still need a second guitar string. And then Sunday, James Soroka, and I'm trying to figure out some new people for the week because I did Repsion this week. We can't do Repsion. We can't do him a lot. He's like every once in a while. Not a lot. But yeah. All right, guys. Goodbye for good now until tomorrow, and I will see you all next time. Bow, bow. Goodbye.